my fellow senator from my state. He was coming back from Edo yesterday, was attacked twice. In fact, two of his policemen are likely ill. They are undergoing operation right now. He came in here and he just left. He had a close shave with death. A lot of us are already thinking, supposing something happens in the night, what do I do with my family? My home, my house is already well known. My office is well known. Where do I hide? So, Mr. President, look, I am not, there is nobody in this country today that is not worried about the issue of insecurity. Nobody. Last night, I watched Governor Bello of Niger on TV, the chief executive of a state. His fears were well expressed by him. And of course, to put it, he said, you can see that the precincts, the satellite towns around Abuja, they are under siege. And if nothing is done in the next few days, Abuja will be the target. Therefore, there is cause for worry. When it is happening to other people, we don't know the gravity until it happens to somebody close to you. This is security of Nigeria, or security in Nigeria, we have been talking about it. It's like a ritual. Nothing is happening. We have stood up here. It's not about condemning the government or a system. What practical steps are we taking to stand this thing? Somebody just said, they're not grandstanding in this business. Nigeria was sent to Mali to quell insurrection some time ago. We have equally gone to other West African states to go and intervene. A lot of Nigerians have raised their voices. Is there any shame? If the Western powers, they have the powers, the arsenal to fight this warfare, why can we not invite them?